Hey everyone, the name is Erik Thor, and today we're talking about the four INFJ subtypes. So there are INFJ and INFI subtypes. These are the most introverted of all INFJs, so they are primarily focused on self-preservation, maintaining a world that is harmonious and stable, preserving steadiness inside, making sure that you live a life that is in tune with your wishes and your needs, focusing on your own needs and preserving your own values and ideals. You seek harmony, and often you do so by avoiding discomfort. You struggle with overwhelm and being pressured by other people, and you feel that the world should slow down. Secondly, we can talk about another subtype, that's the intuitive subtype, now the INFJ-Ni subtype. So this is an INFJ that primarily seeks to formulate theories about the world that they then seek to test and understand. That means they are constantly trying to gather data and information that relates to what they believe about the world. They are trying to prove a theory or an idea. They are trying to establish a concept or gain understanding about something. So this is the theorist INFJ, and so this is an INFJ that is constantly in flux, changing, developing, rethinking, considering new perspectives and alternative viewpoints, always learning, always scattering, but never formulating anything conclusive, and often staying in the brainstorm stage or the reflection stage and refusing to or avoiding to take real action. Third, we can talk about the FI-FE subtype INFJ. This is an INFJ primarily focused on understanding themselves and maintaining and nurturing their own inner compass and values. So this is the kind of INFJ that tries to set a good example for other people, for the world to follow. They are focused on becoming an ideal version of themselves, an ideal they hope other people will follow. Their thought is that by being the best version of myself and by maintaining sound values and ethics, I can get other people on my side and I can make the world a better place. Often this INFJ can have impossible expectations on themselves and other people, forgetting to think logically and rationally about what they need and what they must have to function healthily. Fourth place, we have the INFJ-NIFE subtype. This is the judging subtype INFJ, focused on changing the world. This is the persuader. So often this is an INFJ that has a strong vision or idea for the world and what the world could be. And they are constantly trying to persuade and get other people on board with this vision. They're trying to get other people to see things the way they do. They feel upset that other people are not understanding them correctly, that other people don't get what they are saying. And so they're constantly trying to reach people, working to communicate their ideals and visions, and trying to get other people to come on board. This INFJ can be pushy about their value system and highly idealistic. Last but not least, I've had a lot of people come up to me and say and talk and say they are another kind of subtype, and that's the INFJ-NIFETISENEFITESI subtype. So this is the everything subtype. So a lot of INFJs tend to have a feeling that they are and embody every single cognitive function at once. They're good at everything. They are both the most intelligent and also the most empathetic. They are the most understanding, they are the most wise, they are the most supernaturally badass personality type of all the 16 personality types. So this is the Enneagram 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, SP, SO, SX variation subtype INFJ. And believe it or not, a lot of people identify with this one. The ego tends to want to erase any darkness inside and to avoid looking at anything bad about themselves. And this can be a big problem. Thanks for watching, and see you all in the next video.